So you've chosen a data acquisition instrument, and you've successfully installed the software. So how do you acquire data? In this demonstration, we're going to use a DATAQ Instruments model DI710 with a single pressure transducer, 0 to 100 PSI with a 0 to 5 volt output, connected to channel 1. We'll begin by disabling the channels that we're not using. To do so, we'll choose Channels from the Edit pull-down menu and left-click on channel 2, 3, and 4 to disable those channels. As you can see, the channels are disabled, but the strips are still visible. To display the single strip, we'll choose Format Screen from the View pull-down menu and choose One Waveform. With the single channel displayed, we'll scale to display engineering units, in this case PSI. To do so, we'll choose Engineering Unit Settings from the Edit pull-down menu. And since we know that our transducer outputs 5 volts at 100 PSI, we'll set 5 equal to 100 and 0 equal to 0, since we have 0 volts out at 0 PSI. We'll change the EU tag to PSI and click OK. As you can see, channel 1 now displays 0 to 100 PSI, just like we want. Next, we'll need to choose an appropriate sample rate. Since we're dealing with a relatively slow changing pressure, we'll double-click on the sample rate, in this case 960. Actually, a better way to do this would be to choose sample rate from the Edit pull-down menu and lower the rate to maybe 10 samples a second, which is sufficient for a slowly changing pressure. Your sample rate will vary depending on the signal that you've connected, or the signal that you're acquiring. With the sample rate set, we'll choose Record from the File pull-down menu and specify a file name, in this case, Test. We'll choose our desktop as the destination just to make it easy to find. You'll be prompted for a file size in kilobytes or a record time. In this case, we'll enter a record time in hours, minutes, and seconds. We're just going to record for a couple minutes. Press OK. And that's all there is to it. We're recording data to our desktop, and you can see the percent used at the top to indicate how full the file is. In this case, 0.1%. That number will increase as the file fills up to 100%. You can see we jumped to 13.7. Here you see the file on the desktop. We can double-click on the file to open it in the WinDaq waveform browser. Here you can view and analyze the data.